sunshine of California, we are 5 days away from fundamentally transforming the United States of America.
Ron Meyer helped put that together. He's from Young America's Foundation. He's responsible, yes, for that ad. He joins us live from Detroit this morning. Good morning, Ron.
Good morning from the bailout capital, guys.
You got it. We mentioned that 16.5% rate, the youth unemployment rate. What is happening with this country's youth? Why is it so stubbornly high?
Well, Investor's Business Daily is calling this the Great Youth Depression. I think that's really it. I think statistically it's obvious that it's happening. Youth unemployment is at depression levels, but you also have to remember, young people and students have this massive amount of student debt as well, so it's really this double whammy. So it's worse than really the Great Depression was for young people, especially because young people aren't even participating in the job force. Now, statistics can show this easily, but I've seen it too among my friends. I think young people have seen it everywhere. Now, but the thing is, we have to show why this is happening. Why is this happening to young people? Young people are wondering why, and I don't think their natural inclination is to blame the Obama administration. But guess what? That's why it's happening. And that's why Young America's Foundation is doing these freedom conferences, starting off in Raleigh and then going to Milwaukee, to show young people why it's happening, why it's big government, and why it's the Obama administration, and that's why they're miserable.
But you haven't yet answered that why. Why are young people unemployed at such a high rate, and what does it have to do with the Obama administration?
Well, of course, that's a big charge to make, and I think it's really easily backed up, actually. If you think about government spending, it gives money to government industry, which doesn't hire young people at all. So young people actually get nothing from the government spending. If you think about it, it's a catch-22 for young people. It adds to the debt. Obviously, it doesn't employ them. Young people have taken a worse hit than anybody else. And so young people are left asking, well, why am I miserable? It's because the government is sucking money from the private sector, which largely employs young people, and then giving it to the government, which doesn't. It's a highly unionized government industry that doesn't hire young people because it's seniority-based, and it just takes away economic efficiency altogether.
But what we've seen the last couple of months, Ron, is that government jobs are shrinking. In fact, there's no government jobs created. The last couple of months, they've all been in the private sector.
Well, right, and yeah, I mean, youth unemployment is still persistent. It's because if you think about it, when in a depression or a recession or, you know, a slow recovery, whatever you want to call what we're in right now for young people, if you think about it, people are now taking starter jobs. People with PhDs and master's degrees are taking starter jobs that young people would normally have. So it's going to be a long time until young people see it. The fact is, businesses are still facing a ton of uncertainty because they don't know if their taxes are going to be raised. They know that they're facing a ton of regulation. I mean, right now, businesses are having to spend over $10,000 in federal regulation. That's the Washington Examiner saying that, to hire someone. You think they're going to hire a young person right now?
Yeah.
I mean, of course not.
It's interesting. And you guys' message is being conveyed at the Young America's Foundation Conference in North Carolina on March 23rd. Ron Meyer, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me on.
Appreciate it. Coming up.